was not happy at all in the beginning. And then slowly, when I got started evolving, I think nature has this power of attracting everyone. Any socially conscious person should think about water. Water management is a very, very important issue in my view. And then Swar system is going to play a leading role from that perspective.
In India, the big problem is many farmers are abandoning farming. We want them to get back to farming. And for that, irrigation is a prerequisite, soil improvement is a prerequisite, and that's what Swar aims to deliver. Swar works on gravity flow because electricity is not available with the farmers. And so gravity flow has certain limitations of how much area you can serve. Right? So what we do is we put up an overhead tank, not highly raised. From there we run plastic PVC pipes. From the plastic PVC pipes we run what is called as online pipes. These are basically water conduits. Another source of income is what is called as related business in agriculture, which is dairying, etc. So we need to really understand farmers' requirements in countries like India in a slightly wider context, rather than just looking at comparative advantage of the cow, the comparative advantage of growing grass, etc. I think that's a very Western mindset.
Swar system we have been using only from the past few days. So this we have to experiment, test it out and see, and we would love to replicate it and make it bigger. And I think I'm very hopeful about the Swar system. Already we have been seeing these results.
Swar is very simply having four features. One, Swar takes the water directly to the root of a plant, at the root zone. Two, Swar provides moisture, assured moisture at the root zone. Right? Three, Swar ensures the spread of the moisture through capillary movement. Four, Swar can further reduce the water intake if you want to just keep the plant alive. That's the key features of Swar.